Erupting from the eastern sky, a fireball streaks across Russian airspace and appears to blow apart.
Something is directed towards the object.
And maybe that's what caused it to explode.
Did the Cold War just reignite? Friday morning in Chelyabinsk, an industrial city in southern Russia. Commuters, school children, office workers settle in for the day ahead. 9:20 a.m. A strange, blinding light casts a shadow across the city, bringing people out onto the streets. The light suddenly disappears. Looking to the sky, astonished residents film a vast vapor trail overhead. Minutes later, an explosion rocks the city. Scientists record a blast 25 times larger than Nagasaki. Windows shatter and people fly off their feet. The city's shattered residents try to make sense of this aerial bombardment. Rumors of a hostile act against Russia flood the internet. Politician Vladimir Zhirinovsky even accuses the U.S. of involvement in the strike on the city. In Moscow, NASA scientist Slava Turyashev searches for answers.
There are many conflicting reports. There is a significant anxiety whether or not it's a single event or maybe there will be other events.
While NASA rushes to discover the cause of the cataclysm, the mystery deepens.
The days that follow this sensational event, word begins to spread. Maybe there was something else going on.
There are news feeds that seem to indicate that as this thing is entering the atmosphere as a glowing fireball, that something is directed towards the object, possibly stopping it, possibly breaking it up.
People are saying, yeah, something came towards it and seemed to hit it. And maybe that's what caused it to explode.
Images of the fireball's strange collision capture the public imagination. But when NASA studies the entire event, building a moment-by-moment timeline from dozens of different cameras, they see a different phenomenon. The people of Chelyabinsk witnessed a meteor disintegrating as it smashed through Earth's atmosphere.
As this object comes through the atmosphere, pieces are breaking apart. You see stuff flying in different directions. It's very easy to get a perception of something very odd. After all, this is an incredibly rare event.
The fireball's interceptor is really a fragment of the meteor keeping pace with the fireball. But NASA's explanation doesn't satisfy the citizens of Chelyabinsk, who are left with a devastated city. While searching for an impact crater that matches the explosive shockwave, they find nothing bigger than a swimming pool. The idea that whatever created the tiny impacts could also topple a city seems laughable. But according to Professor Lawrence Garvey, an expert in meteorites, the destruction in Chelyabinsk could be explained by the physics of a large, fast-moving object streaking through the atmosphere.
What we're seeing first with the Chelyabinsk meteor is its visual effect. It's coming in, it's breaking up. We're not hearing anything because the light is traveling to us almost instantaneously. We can see it immediately. But as we're looking at it, we're unaware that traveling towards us at the speed of sound is the shockwave. And it's almost like a fist punching a window really hard. But punching every single window in the town at the same time.
The energy released as the supersonic rock disintegrated above the city explains the destructive shockwave. But the devastation could have been far worse. The Earth's atmosphere shielded Chelyabinsk against the meteorite's full potential. NASA calculations suggest that our natural defenses only worked because the meteor was made of relatively soft rock. Had the 60-foot-wide meteor been made of metal instead, it could have released the energy of 60 Nagasakis.
Here in Arizona, we have the perfect example of what would happen. What looks like a 45-meter hill here is actually the edge, the rim of this spectacular crater. This gives you some sense of what a large meteor impact would do.
There are more than 80,000 metallic asteroids floating near us in space. Some of them may even be heading our way right now. In March 2012, astronomers monitoring images from a solar telescope in Earth's orbit see something ominous just to the west of the sun's south pole.
What the heck is that? It's Darth Vader's big vehicle, of course.
It looks like the Death Star from Star Wars.
Certainly hope is not a Death Star. Otherwise, we're in serious trouble.
Planet-sized tendrils appear to connect the globe of darkness to the sun's surface. This connection fuels speculation that the sinister sphere's presence near our star is no coincidence.
Why would anybody visit the sun? Well, it might be a good place to refuel.
The sun burns hydrogen, the perfect fuel for a starship.
Could spaceships be refueling by getting as close as possible to stars and sapping up that energy, and that's what's fueling them through space? That image certainly raises that possibility.
The sun puts out more power in a second than humanity has used in all of history.
But the 3 million degree temperatures in the sun's atmosphere would destroy any human technology.
We can't use the sun for a spacecraft, but that doesn't mean some very advanced alien race can't.
It would require some massive engineering advances. You don't want this spacecraft to vaporize.
It's not insane to think there is an unobtainium that is what you need to be able to build a Death Star that can roll right into a star to refuel. All it is a matter of being able to handle the heat.
Once the Death Star's fuel tank is filled, the colossal nozzle detaches, and the craft zooms off to wreak mayhem elsewhere in the galaxy. It's an incredible idea, too incredible for NASA, who come up with their own explanation for the black orb, involving equally astonishing non-alien phenomena.
We're looking at a prominence in a magnetic bubble. It's the magnetic bubble that looks like a big Death Star.
The tendrils are prominences. Clouds of hydrogen cling to the edge of the sun's atmosphere. The Death Star itself is a solar magnetic bubble the size of Jupiter, full of superhot plasma. The only thing holding the ball in place is a magnetic field, which can shift at any moment.
Eventually they erupt, and that's what we're seeing at the end, this eruption off into space. So even though we don't see it here on Earth, there are these huge explosions going on in the sun all the time.
Even if the NASA footage hasn't captured a planet-destroying Death Star, our sun is still a very real threat to civilization on Earth. The eruption seen here is a coronal mass ejection. It releases 1,000 times more energy than the Death Star bubble. If we take a hit from one of these, it can wreak havoc on Earth.
These things can knock out satellites. Electronics won't function.
It has effects on communications. It has effects on the power grids and power distribution.
Even worse, wild variations in solar activity can push the Earth into prolonged ice ages.